Did you do any other work in Birkenau, or were you just in the Sonderkommando?
Well, I was now working at the Sonderkommando, but I met a German, which I knew him from home, and we spoke straight that the war wouldn't be lasting in Hitler's favor. The war will turn around. And he went my way, and as I was working in the Sonderkommando, I was searching afterwards, and I did get a different position of work. I did get a position of working with the clothing, with the silver, gold.
And sorting out the possessions?
Sorting out possessions. And I did prepare with this guy to escape or prepare whatever it was. I did wind up having a little bottle of diamonds what we're supposed to give in to the Germans. I wound up putting it in a bottle and preparing eventually to escape with the German. But it didn't come so straight. I had the bottle hidden into my bed, and someone had the block elves there, which it's also one of the flickling, you know, one of the Jews or German or Polish, where they're getting better treated.
Mm-hmm.
They had an inspection in the barracks. In the scene that my bed wasn't made right. And they touched the bed and the bottle of diamond fell out. And they got me. So I didn't tell it's mine. I didn't want to tell them it's mine or I'm partnered with somebody. They gave me S-car. I get to work in S-car. S-car means Strafkommando. Over there, you live 2 days or 3 days tops. But being I had the German was watching me over me, watching every move they made with me. There was a transport going to Jaworzno to work in a coal mine. He threw me right out of the line from Eskar line, threw me into the line going away to Jaworzno.
Why did people only last a day or two in the Eskar?
Because Eskar, the name of Eskar means Strafkommando. You bend over, you're getting hit. You're standing up, you're getting hit. You go turning over, you're getting hit. You're carrying anything, you're getting hit. If anything you're doing, you're getting hit with it. You work, you walk, you're getting hit by walking. Whatever you do, you're getting hit by it. Till you lay down and quit. If you quit, they call in a guy and shoot you.
So how long did it take to get to the coal mine?
Now, that was my luck, that the guy just threw me in on the transport. And this is, Jaworzno is about 30 kilometers from Auschwitz,
from Birkenau.
And I got out there. 2 weeks later, he transferred himself over to Jaworzno.
The German?
The German transferred himself over to Jaworzno. And thank God, I lived through it. But I went to work in a coal mine. I had better privileges through him. I become a prizefighter.
You had been boxing when you were a teenager?
Yes. I was a prizefighter in the house, in my home. But now, over here, I had the privilege, they had boxing shows for every Sunday.
So the Germans sponsored you to be
there? The Germans, yes. So it was actually boxing to the finish. You know, one of us had to lay down and... It's not just the professional fighting or amateur fighting. It was just entertaining the Germans. I knew how to do it, and I survived. Besides, if I wouldn't survive in the ring, he would have took me out not to let me get further because he was there. And I worked in the coal mine. He sent me. I had to go to work the coal mine. I did not work too much too hard in the coal mine because he gave me clothes to sell it to the Polacks.
So you were able to get food?
I used to have food for myself and whiskey for him and chocolate for him and everything. And at the same time, I made good, I had an infection in my foot. I had to go to the hospital, and I made a friend, a doctor. He was also a prisoner, but he was a doctor from Czechoslovakia. I told him, listen, give me easy work. Don't send me, you know, because every week a transport went to the oven, to the Auschwitz. They're very thick, you know, crippled, you had to go to Auschwitz. So I said, you know, you're not in no trouble, but you'll be all right. I ran away, gave him chocolate and whatever I had left. I said, look, you take care of me, and I'll take care of you. Going by the time, they did take all the Jews from lodge. Well, I worked there in camp. It must have gone out at least a year. And I had easier time than I had all up to now. I was strong, big, tremendous strong. A friend of ours from town, from my hometown, from Belchatov, what was in the camp in Yavozhno, waited to 2 o'clock at night. The reason was my shift to the coal mine was from 12 to 2. We came in, we used to go on a chain gang at 2 o'clock and come at 12 o'clock and come back at 2 o'clock at night. And this guy waited for me because he knew that I was a big shot in the camp. I had a lot of privileges in camp that he waited to tell me that my brother brought in my brother from the ghetto from lodge. They liquidated the ghetto from lodge.
Which brother?
An older brother of mine. His name is Peret. When he waited a half a night, because he knew that he'll wait and tell me, he'll get a piece of a portion of bread or whatever, I'll treat him for I wouldn't give him no money. He don't need no money. He can't buy no money, but I'll treat him with something. And that's what happened. He did get for me a loaf of bread. In the morning, I walked over. I was in barrack. You know, we had barracks. 13 up, you know. And my brother, the arrivals, they were on 5. But I had connections with the big shots from the Black Elster, you know, the guys where they run in the barracks. Every morning they counted the camp. Every morning the camp had to register X amount of money, X amount of prisoners, and everyone had to be counted, staying up and be counted. When I got over to the barrack where my brother was, I called his name, and when they got him out, he saluted to me because he didn't recognize me. I was real heavy. You know, it happened that, thank God, it's German. Everything I had, I live it because of this German.
Do you remember his name?
No.
So your own brother didn't recognize you?
If I remember his name, his name is A Million and One Smith. Okay. A Million and One Smith. So okay. But my own brother saluted for me, not just didn't recognize, saluted for me. Till I told, hey, you don't recognize your brother? Then he fell forward and kissed me. Now, I asked him to be sent on an to get an easy job in the mine. Yeah, he got an easy job, but he was unfortunate. His foot got caught by the wire. He broke his foot. Now they brought him into to the hospital. Otherwise, if he wouldn't be my brother, he would have gone the thing a week later to Auschwitz. He was my brother. I went to see the doctor. The doctor seen chocolate and whiskey, and he was left. He got healed out in camp. He survived because I had a little pull with moving around.